Hi, I'm Duncan, the technical trainer at Enphase. In this short video, I will give you the best Enphase Installer App workflow for fast and efficient commissioning of an Enphase Energy System. Now, to begin commissioning an Enphase system, you will need a smartphone or tablet with internet access and the Enphase Installer Toolkit app. Now, you can download the app for free from the App Store or Google Play. Even if you are an existing installer of Enphase, before you begin commissioning, all installers must have completed the Enphase Energy System certification course at the Enphase University. Your app will not allow you to proceed if you are not certified. You will need to connect the IQ system controller to your customer's internet by Ethernet cable or Wi-Fi. Now, if you choose the Wi-Fi option, you will need your customer's Wi-Fi password. Now, first switch on the AC grid supply to the IQ system controller and confirm that it's ready for commissioning. As it powers up, the LEDs will flash red for a couple of minutes. And we're now ready to commission. So open up your app, follow the screen prompts to log in, and remember to select auto download over Wi-Fi and cellular. If you find you need extra support with any of the commissioning stages, please refer to the video library where you can view all the information on the various stages in more detail. Now let's begin commissioning. Return to the Systems tab, and for new systems, press the plus button on the bottom right and enter the site details. Complete all of the required fields. You'll also need the customer's information, including their email address. Otherwise, for existing sites, if you're adding IQ batteries to an existing site, please select the system name from the list. Then select Request Return and Install Replacement. Then select Replace IQ Gateway. Once you've finished system details, you'll move to Stage 2, Devices in Array. Now I'm going to show you how to program device serial numbers when you commission an Enphase Energy System, including a simple method for quick scanning of the devices. But before you start the task, ensure that the DC switch on the front of the battery is turned off. The LED should now show red. Begin by adding the number of devices to be installed on site. An existing site will already include the number of microinverters. You will only need to scan for new devices installed. As you're already Enphase certified, you can proceed. Now follow the prompts to add the devices. Find the serial number for each device and then scan it so that it can be added to the installer app. Begin by scanning the IQ Gateway serial number, previously known as the Envoy. Once you've scanned the IQ Gateway serial number, select the grid profile for the site location, and then scan the remaining devices. A simple way to do this for each of the microinverters for the solar PV arrays is to use the serial number stickers on the array map. Next, scan the IQ system controller. And finally, each IQ battery. Once each device has been scanned, you're now ready to move on to stage 3. Stage 1 and 2 are now complete, however you may choose to visit Stage 2B later on. This is the Auxiliary Relay Configuration stage. Now for details, visit the Document Center on the Enphase website. And this is how to ensure IQ Gateway connectivity when commissioning an Enphase Energy System. Follow the screen prompts to connect your phone's Wi-Fi to the IQ Gateway. To enable this process, you will need to press the AP Mode button on the IQ Gateway. Wait for the screen to update to show the connections are completed and then select Join. And then join the Wi-Fi network. My phone is now connected to the IQ Gateway. For internet connection, you can use either Ethernet or Wi-Fi. In this example, I will connect using Wi-Fi, so I need to find the customer's Wi-Fi network and enter their password to connect the IQ Gateway to the internet. You can see that my phone is now connected to the IQ Gateway, and this is in turn connected successfully to the internet via the customer's modem. There is also a red indication, meaning that my phone does not have an internet connection. This is the correct outcome. This is because I'm directly connected to the IQ Gateway using the phone's Wi-Fi. Now, let's go through how to provision devices when commissioning an Enphase Energy System. And to begin, select Start Provisioning Devices. This will send any required updates to the devices. It may take a few moments to complete, and you may choose to wait until each device shows that provisioning is completed. Then click Continue. I'm now going to take you through how to perform system validation when commissioning an Enphase Energy System. So to begin, click back to the validation from the homepage. Select Production Meter. Turn on the battery's DC switch. Check that the LED is green, then click OK. I will now take you through the validation steps. First, select the number of phases of solar that are wired into the system controller. If you are new to Enphase commissioning, you can also choose to run through the metering wizard, which will give you a detailed step-by-step check to confirm the CT reading is as you expect. Otherwise, select No, I'm an expert to turn on the CT and view the readings. You're required to enable the internal CT metering of the IQ system controller. Before you press enable, be sure to confirm the readings look correct. The value should always be positive and the power factor should be 1 or close to 1. If the power factor is very low, for example 0.3, then check your wiring for correct phase connections. It is always good to check this reading. Production metering is set. Now let's complete consumption metering. We will now commission and enable the consumption meter. First select the phase number. And again, in this example, I'm selecting No, I'm an expert. Although the meter is pre-wired, you will need to select the meter location, which will be load with solar for all Australia and New Zealand installations. Now enable the CT. Keep checking the measurements. The power reading in this example is now showing exporting to grid and negative values in the power readings. You expect to see a negative value when the solar is exporting power to the grid. You can also turn on known loads. At this point, it is always good to validate these readings, so get an AC clamp meter and physically measure the current in the wiring and check if your measurements match the installer app reading. If the measurements look incorrect, go back and recheck your wiring to ensure all of the connections are correct. If it is a multi-phase site, confirm that each phase is wired correctly across the site and into the designated terminals at the IQ system controller. Enable the consumption CT. You will now complete functional validation. This is where the energy system will test that your installation can operate and transition between on and off-grid modes. For each of these six steps, follow the on-screen instructions and toggle the switch to the top right of the screen when instructed. For step 2, you will check that the load is less than the capacity of the IQ batteries. Once you've confirmed this, toggle the switch to off-grid. You are now running in off-grid mode. The loads are running directly off the Enphase Energy System. Turn on more loads to ensure the system is supporting the load and continue to work in off-grid mode. In step 5, you'll now switch the system back to on-grid mode. Step 6, the final step, will automatically create your system summary, which can be emailed using the link. We can now be confident the system is operational, so let's move on to stage 6 and review the post-commissioning steps. Click Continue. And finally, let's go through how to complete post-commissioning steps for the Enphase Energy System. For this stage, you will need to disconnect from the IQ Gateway Wi-Fi AP. Simply turn off your phone's Wi-Fi or disconnect Gateway in the Wi-Fi settings. Note the status tab changes to orange. The IQ summary report will be generated. A homeowner walkthrough page will pop up automatically. Go through each option with the customer, then confirm all of the steps have been completed. Well done, commissioning completed. You can now configure the tariff. Click back to post-commissioning. To set the tariff amounts, you will need a copy of the customer's power bill for the correct information. You can also set storage configuration, which will determine how the battery energy is used. Self-consumption mode will prioritise the battery and solar, minimising the amount of electricity being purchased from the grid. and you can also set the backup reserve capacity to guarantee there will always be the battery energy available when the system is operating in off-grid mode. And then click Save. And there you have it! You've successfully commissioned an Enphase Energy System. So thanks for watching.